Hello everybody, this is Commissar here, and today I will be bringing you a 1v1 StarCraft 2 commentary. And today's match is a Korean match actually. I did download a TLO replay pack, however I figured since I've casted TLO so much lately, I would actually cast the one game which was not TLO in that pack, which I believe has not been casted by anybody else at this point. Okay, so today's match is from the Korean server, as I said, between two Korean Grandmasters, the first of whom is OGS Hero from the clan OGS, possibly the biggest clan in Korea, I don't know, well, one of the top clans in Korea, I'm not going to say who's the biggest, I don't know enough about Korea myself. Hero himself is ranked 119 in the Grandmaster League in Korea, so he's very, very highly ranked. He has about a 60% win-loss ratio, and he's also in the MLG event at the moment. He's been at MLG Rally, and he's one of the few players who has not yet lost in MLG. He's still in it, he's in round 3 of the Losers Championship bracket. Okay. So that's Hero, so he's obviously a very, very top player. His opponent, being Feifei, is a player who I'm not very familiar with whatsoever. Feifei is also in the Korean Grandmaster League. He is ranked 124. So both players ranked very closely together, although Feifei actually only has a 49% win rate. So he wins about almost exactly 50% of the time. Hero wins a little more than that. So why that would suggest that Hero is a bit of a favorite. He is from the clan which I am more familiar with, so I'd have to suggest that indeed he probably is the favorite, but it's still, I don't really know enough about it to comment. It's still going to be very even regardless. So anyway, looking at what both players are doing so far, the map is, I forget the name of this map, I think it might be Typhoon Peaks, but I'm not entirely sure, I forget that. And we are seeing Feifei go for a 15 hatch. So the significance of this 15 hatch is that it might be difficult to defend. I think that seeing that it is cross positions on this map, it is a fairly large map. It's not one of the super macro maps, but yeah, it is large for two players to be playing on. I think that will probably be a safe move by Feifei, and we are seeing no sign of any sort of early zealot pressure or early cannon pressure from Hero, which would seek to deny this expansion. Although this probe is being a bit of a nuisance, forcing Feifei to pull one drone. Okay, so we do have a nice overlord positioning, I will say, by Feifei. Keeping an overlord down here, although it's not actually a very nice position, it probably should be at the back of the mineral line, just to make sure that your opponent is not trying to put any cannons there. Although seeing as he does have a drone in the base of his opponent, that's not really an issue, because he knows that there are no cannons in the way, because he knows that there is no forge. So we see Hero taking his second gas at a fairly standard timing, so he's probably going to be taking up into some sort of a Robotech, I'd assume that means, just because... Well, not necessarily Robotech, but he's likely to be taking up to something. And there's a little bit of a lag spike there, sorry about that. I did try to turn the graphics settings up, we'll see if it makes it a little bit laggy, but it did just then, but now it's up to 90 frames a second, so I don't know. We'll just have to wait and see if that's okay. If not, I'll turn it back down again. Also, I would like to say that I did turn up the brightness, which a lot of people would suggest, so you may notice a difference in the brightness in this video. So okay, we are seeing Hero get out chrono boosting quite heavily at this first stalker, which is standard chrono boost at the stalker if you do miss your first zealot. And he's also getting a sentry, which is going to be make defense of any sort of early rush very easy. But seeing as Feifei did get that 15 hatch, it's unlikely that he'll transition into an all-in Ling rush. Okay, so Feifei is actually continuing to drone up. He does have his two queens about to pop at the same time. I believe at the same time, well, almost at the same time. The specifics are not exactly too significant. And I believe, I'm just going to pause this now because it is lagging a bit. I will actually turn on the graphics. Okay, sorry about that. It turns out I actually changed the textures, not the graphics, so it probably didn't even make much of a difference at all. And now the frame rate's a lot higher, so that's probably something that we can all live with. And now I'm back to normal, but a little bit brighter. Okay, so we are seeing 3 gates now coming out for OGS Hero, so he is probably going to go into 3 gate expand, I would assume, in response to this expansion from his opponent. And sitting out a stalker, perhaps not the wisest thing to do here, potentially could get surrounded by these lings, although it looks like Feifei, for some reason, has been quite reluctant about engaging this directly. Apparently he's trying to not lose anything, but at the same time, if he doesn't actually scare away the stalker, he might end up losing a queen, which would be a pretty big blow at this stage. And this stalker, in fact, it's a queen kill, that would be quite huge, and, ooh, it might actually, but no, the Zerglings are now going to commit. I don't know why they didn't commit earlier, but you can see Brilliant Micro by Hero, able to get away the Stalker with full health, basically, blow its shields, only losing 7 actual health. So we are seeing now 3 sentries out for Hero, which does indicate that the expansion will be on the way, which has now been placed down, and apparently Hero doesn't like small animals. Okay, so Hero's heavy sentry build, it is, well, obviously twofold, it is standard though, it means lots of force fields, lots of easy defense, at the same time it means you have lots of minerals that are not being spent, so you can afford the expansion, and then you can also help to afford extra gateways and things to add on afterwards. That's why you need the second early gas, 2-5-6-man like that, just to get out all those sentries. It's one of Bin Control's favourite builds through this sort of heavy sentry 3-8 expand, and we are indeed seeing Feifei respond by throwing down a hatchery here. Because it can be quite hard to apply any immediate pressure after expanding as a Protoss player, although a 6-gate all-in is also a possibility. But a Stargate is indeed what's in the way for our Korean hero. I didn't mean that he's our hero, that's his name, but the Stargate is indeed on the way. So, this is going to be interesting, because I don't often see Stargates this delayed in PvZ. I often see Stargates just in general, because people like to, say, go for some early Phoenixes or some early Void Rays, put on some early pressure. But seeing as it's barely advanced into the game, we're already 8 minutes in, it normally wouldn't be that significant, but I think a big factor here might be the fact that Feifei has taken this third. And does Hero know about it? No, he doesn't know about this third base. He does get it know it now, because you can see this this probe over here is going to spot the creep here, so now he knows about it, and you can see he's moved that unit a little bit, so he knows there's a base down here now. So he's probably going to be very happy about his choice to go for Stargate, and he is indeed moving out across the map now, bringing a probe, I assume, just to place a proxy pylon down as he moves out. Also, a forge can allow for that plus one attack to get chrono boosted out, as well as allowing for only one gas geyser and a bunch more minerals to be secured. Also, the cannon will help to secure the expansion. Okay, so Hero was just poking out there. As you can see, there are only drones in the way for Hero, so he was not poking out to try and scare his opponent and intimidate him, apparently, because we can obviously see that the Zerg player has not been intimidated whatsoever. So I think Hero warping this pylon in position such that Zealots could be walked onto the low ground to harass this mineral line. We'll have to see if that is what he does, and no, he's going for some cannons. So I wonder if these cannons will be in range of the low ground. I have a feeling that this cannon here will be able to shoot drones down here, and the other two might be just for defense. They will certainly be able to lock down the gas too. A nice little move by Hero, and possibly a spot where we should see an Overlord flown over by Feifei to help watch this high ground. Okay, so we are seeing Hero now move out with another small force. He does have lots of forceful energy, but it's not really too dangerous to move out. Not going to lose that Stalker, so he's actually completely fine. So he's just moving out, I think, more to poke, to just sort of put his opponent under a little bit of pressure, trying to force him to stop droning so hard, because as you can see in the income tab, we already have 73 drones for Feifei. And the cannons now coming to full effect, possibly a couple too many cannons. I think it might be a bit of an overcommitment, considering that it is a bit of an Artosis pylon here. Maybe he wants to throw down an extra pylon if he wants to have 5 cannons. Okay, so this is really good though, because these cannons are actually covering the Stalker, so it is scaring away the Queen, and that's also going to make it difficult for these Queens to attack this Void Ray, because there is indeed support for this Void Ray. Which is, I like this move very much by Hero, it's going to do a lot of damage, but at the same time, I still don't think it puts Hero ahead, because he is so far behind in the Harvest account, and it's still, this is the third base, not the second base, so Feifei's certainly not in bad shape by any means. Feifei also getting out a ton of roaches at the moment, but unfortunately roaches can't shoot up, so it'll be a bit difficult to hold off this attack with just roaches, and we have seen the second pylon go down here, so that there's no Artosis pylon business. Uprooting the spine claws at a difficult time, and we are seeing Zerglings just charge in despite the cannon positioning, which I don't think is a good move by Feifei. I think he's just panicking a little bit under the pressure, although the nice spine crawler work is actually there. So I believe the reason he charged forward there was just to allow the spine crawlers to root, because the spine crawlers can outrange these cannons if they have an overlord to spot the high ground for them. But at the same time, the overlord could always be killed off by this Void Ray if that is what happens. So it's a bit of an awkward stalemate, I'd say, over this space, and ultimately, Feifei is the loser there, because he cannot mine at the moment, except for one gas geyser. Okay, so Feifei's tech, he is finally, does he have a lair? I'm not even sure. Yeah, he does have a lair, and he does have an infestation pit, and he is getting pathogen gland, so we'll certainly be seeing some infestor play. That's not just for any sort of hive tech rush, and in the meantime, we are seeing Hero move out, but not with a very large army. He still doesn't have very much of an air force, only that one Void Ray from earlier, I think. He just got that out for a single Void Ray. Other than that, it's just been production of 3 gates so far. 3 more have been added on. No, 2 more and a robotics bay have been added on. So we will see some Colossi come out very quickly. And I assume that Hero won't really commit to a large attack until he does have that robotics bay out. So the reason why this attack has been so brilliant for Hero is because it wasn't a too big investment. It was a significant investment, but it's already paid for itself a few times over. And really, this is a really nice position to have at the back of the map. You can continue to harass, and it has screwed up Feifei a bit in terms of he's now oversaturated off 2 base. 73 probe drones is way too much to have off 2 base, although a couple have actually died too, but 67 is still too much. And here we are seeing a big attack by Feifei on the destructible rocks of the back 4 Hero. Hiro is moving to position, he does know about it, but at the same time it is going to make it difficult for him to secure the expansion, and he will have Force Fields on the ramp in time though, and it looks like, oh, we are seeing some Lings get isolated here, so that was actually really nice there by Hiro to get those free Zergling kills. I call it free because this Force Field energy isn't too significant when you have so many sentries and so much energy, and here we might see Feifei overcommitting here. I don't think he should be charging in with so much Force Field energy, and no, he's just being forced to run out again, losing a ton of Lings in that battle, and you'll see. The unit's last tab is very lopsided indeed, partly because of the cannons over here, partly because of that little cluster play there, but at the same time, unit's last, you also have to consider these cannons, these pylons, well, more the cannons than the pylons, because the pylons provide supply, but the cannons are unit's last too. And Hiro is sacrificing his Void Ray there just to kill a Spine Crawler. I'm not quite sure why he did that, but he has scattered the Infestors too with that Void Ray, so he certainly knows to expect Infestors. And if we, unless we see Neural Parasite, it'll be very hard for those Infestors to... For the investors to deal with the Colossus deck. And do we have Neural Parasite? I'm not actually sure if it has been researched or not. No, we do not. So that's going to be something that possibly Feifei will want to be getting anytime, sometime soon. So Feifei looking like he might want to expand down here, but he is actually going to clear out these cannons. Charging cannons is never economical, except in this instance, because in this instance we are seeing no mining being allowed because of these cannons, and focusing down the pylons always going to be better than attacking the cannons head-on, but the cannons certainly did pay for themselves. Even got a few Zergling kills in that last battle, as you can see by the bloodstains there. Okay, so I expect Feifei to throw down a new hatchery here soon, but we have seen Hiro onto three bases, so I'd say the macro game is favouring Feifei a bit at this stage, mostly because of the harvest account, but Hiro is still in it. He's not behind, he's not out of the game by any means. He's also a bit behind in the food count. Big setback to him is the Colossus count, though. As soon as that starts to get quite high, like maybe three, four Colossi, then he'll be in really good shape, I think, in terms of his army. And he doesn't have to worry about too much anytime soon. It's actually quite a close game so far. So in terms of upgrades, we only have this one attack upgrade, from the melee units for the Zerg, so not very heavy in the upgrades, and we do have 1-1 upgrades for the ground of the Protoss player. Protoss player about to finish the second attack upgrade for his ground, but 33 Banelings are just warped at once here. They do not have Baneling speed though, and the creep threat is not too good, it's not at Hero's base, so I don't know if these Banelings will be able to do much until the speed is done, but 28 more Banelings on the way. It looks like we might be seeing a bit of a Baneling all-in here from Feifei. He's actually loading them up into Overlord, so you'll see some significant Bane Rain here, so this Baneling drops will be huge, and this is a brilliant tactic. I love to see Baneling drops by a Zerg player in this matchup. It's just so, so powerful. It's been used quite a lot lately. I still think it is underused, though. I think it should be used almost all the time, because it is just so, such a brilliant tactic. If you just drop on your opponent's armies, if they force field, they can trap themselves in with force field, and the Banelings are unstoppable. Banelings kill sentries almost instantly. They kill stalkers fairly well, though stalkers can blink out of the way, but they can isolate your Colossi too. If the stalkers blink out, the Colossi get isolated and they die too. So Bane Rain is just so, so powerful if achieved correctly. It's very hard to micro though. Okay, so still no more upgrades from Feifei. He's just going to be doing a Baneling push here, really, with a couple of Infestors of the high energy too, and we are seeing a Hiro just pokeboard with one Colossus, just testing the water a bit here, and he is actually going to keep all his units alive except for one Stalker, but we do also see a high Templar switch from our Protoss player, but he does not have Storm yet, so they won't be able to do anything except to feed back the Infestors, and nice Force Fields are going to delay any sort of engagement here. Going to isolate one Stalker though, so which will die. He's trying to buy time here, I think, until the Storm is done. Storm is going to be brilliant to fight off these Lings, to fight off these Roaches, to fight off the Banelings too, as well as kill the Overlords before they drop anything. But feedback, I think, is the reason why he got the High Templar in the first place, more so than the Storm, just because of the Infestor switch, and you can always feedback Infestors and one-shot them. Even after Frontal Growth, they still get one-shotted when they're on full energy, like they are now. So you are seeing a 4 Colossi timing push, it looks like. No, he's just going to poke out, just going to kill a few Lings. So maybe going to do a timing push, I'm not quite... Yep. Now it looks like he's going to push, and he does have his fourth base down as well for Hiro. So Hiro he's playing very well, he's controlling the pace of the game a bit, he is he's just controlling when Feifei can attack with his high force field count, and he's just doing a nice job of keeping on top of things, keeping on top of his upgrades, and he has been chrono boosting out this one forge most of the game, certainly been researching constantly, with weapons level 3 almost finished. So we are seeing a Baneling drop on the mineral line over here. Will it get taken down? I think maybe could get a few kills on the units, no. Gonna lose all of those Banelings, two Overlords for nothing, but it's still a good attempt by Feifei. At the same time though, the Stalkers are just completely on top of it, so well done to Hiro for spotting that. So you're now moving out with some Blinkstalkers. Maybe gonna blink onto the high ground, we'll have to see. No, he's not. He's just gonna wait for his army to group up. And he's going to move out now with Storm completed. He's also going to be a 3-attack timing push, I believe, about to come out of Hero as 3-timing... The attack is about to complete, but no, there's been engagement before that is finished, and one Stalker getting isolated, but now here come the Storms, all over the Lings, all over the Balings, and they're just demolishing the entire army of Feifei. The Baling Rain is coming down, though, and oh my god, the micro of Hero was just so phenomenal. You can see the units are really on low health from Hero, but it just doesn't matter, because at this point in the game, that was just such an annihilation there. The army of Feifei is dead, he hasn't been able to do anything, and he's also supply blocked because he lost all of his overlords, so he is in a world of hurt right now. He does have 30 changelings, about to die too. So this is really, really, really horrible stuff from the perspective of Feifei. 12 overlords being built at once, 44 lings at once. He is now not supply blocked, he can now start to make lots and lots of units, but it looks like all he has got on the way is lings, probably going to be more banelings. Is he going to drop them? I don't know, because Hero's micro there, which is so, so brilliant. The Storms just annihilated the lings so fast, that's why we need some upgrades from Feifei. He doesn't have 2-1 upgrades, so he is working on the upgrades, but Hero does still have the advantage at 3-1, and DT Shrine is on the way. More upgrades though for Azog player, we'll see him catch up on the upgrade count. So Hero doing some brilliant harassment over here. It's going to potentially take out a lot of drones if it takes out the attacking units first, focusing down the hatchery actually. That's an interesting move by Hero, and it looks like it'll actually work there. So really, really nice play by Hero. If you can save any zealots, that'd be great too with his Warp Prism. But no, his Warp Prism is moving on to do another big zealot push over here at the main base of Hero. And I don't know what they're trying to focus down. Maybe gonna try and focus down the Infestor fit. I don't know. I really don't know, but pushing along the Archon while spawning always a nice move, and we do have an Archon and a few Zealots in the base now. Meanwhile, we are seeing Hero also push forward at the front, so this multi-pronged play is really forcing Feifei to go all over the place. You can see on the minimap he's running all over the place with a limited number of units, but 23 archers are on the way to make his army significant. Nice transfuses going on there too. No, he didn't transfuse. I just said nice transfuses, and then he failed to transfuse again. So a bit of a miss micro there by Feifei, losing queens when he really shouldn't be. Should have transfused them, but the attack has finally been cleaned up, didn't do too much damage to the main, just split up the army. But Feifei does have a bunch of links and an Infestor at the back. I don't know if he knows about these. He appears to have forgotten where he placed this army, because he doesn't have them hotkeyed either. So that might be a bit of an awkward situation for Feifei if he doesn't find those units. He does have an Ultra Cavern though, done. 3 Ultras on the way. And meanwhile, we're just seeing Hero just poke around the front continuously. Look, as you can see, this army isn't on that high health after the Baneling drops from earlier. The Colossus count is not very high either. Although, are there any more Colossi on the map? No, there are not. So just mostly a high Templar force with 15 HTs actually out on the map. Not all of them are in this army too. I think it's being left back for defense all over the place. Yes, they are. So there will be high Templars to storm any sort of counterattacks anywhere for Hero. Really, really nice play there. I'm really impressed by Hero's play. Also going to be doing a Zealot High Templar drop, which will be spotted here, but we do have Warp Prism speed completed for Hero, and Warp Prisms very rarely move that quickly, but the drop has completed. The Warp Prism is down, but at the same time, we could see a feed wreck on the Queen, we could see Storms on the Mineral Line, just have to wait and see what we see, but the drones have evacuated. Although, we are seeing Feifei mine from the wrong patch. He is long distance mining here, now going to go back to this new hatchery, which has just been completed, and an Archon in the back here could cause a lot of trouble for Feifei. He needs to evacuate his overlords and his drones, I think, but he's not focusing on it because there's a big battle over here, and I'm actually going to wind back a little second here because I actually was focusing on a little bit of harass when there was a big battle going on. You are seeing Hero poking forward in the front, and he is going to take down these rocks to the third base of our Feifei. Sorry about going back there, and we are seeing the big army here. I'm just going to pause it right there. 3 ultras, not the most menacing units, considering there are only 3 of them. There is an immortal though, not many Colossi, so the ultras could be significant, could be hard to take down. At the same time, those storms could take out most of the roaches, I think, and the banelings. Infestors though will be crucial in this battle too, to try and hold in the stalkers in place so that they cannot blink away. We'll just wait and see what does happen. And the ultras, you can see, going down quite quickly. It looks like we're taking out a Colossus here. The Colossi are being trapped in the front by these fungal growths, and we're actually seeing Feifei do surprisingly well here, I think, considering he did have some brilliant fungal growths there too. Cleaning up the back, the flanking by Hero, but at the same time, with a pretty even the upend advantage in Hero's favor, his stalkers are doing a very nice job against these roaches, and killing actually a superior force in numbers there. They were a bit softened up by these storms earlier, so really nice micro by Hero, able to make sure that he's not too far behind, but at the same time, we are seeing a big move by Hero. He did have a Warp Prism warping in a ton of Zealots at this back, point here. And he is killing quite a few workers, quite a few queens too. And this is putting Feifei in a really, really bad situation because his army is mostly dead. The Stalkers are continuing to do more pushing here. And Feifei does not have the money to actually rebuild his army as quickly as he would like to. He does have 32 links, 3 ultras on the way. But is that enough? I don't know. It's going to be close. He does have enough numerically, but they'll be in the wrong positions. They'll be all over the place. Now they're coming together. Now they're moving out to clean up the army of Hero, but with an upgrade advantage. This one Archon, 15 kills already, going to be very hard to kill with just Lings, and this will be awkward. Feifei does have a few drones not really doing anything over here. He's trying to micro all over the place at the moment, and he does have a bunch more Banelings. He finally found the Banelings and the Infestor at the back of his base. That could have been crucial. He may have won the battle just back here if he realized that he had them, but I think he forgot about them indeed. Okay, so Feifei now realizing where all of his food is, and is now in a horrible position. It looks like it might be a little bit too late to realize, and we are seeing the Zealots and an Archon move in to the business space for Hero. He does have Stalkers and an Archon on the high ground, so I really think it'll be hard for Feifei to do anything, but the Banelings are coming in now, there are Ultras here too, so he will save this space, it looks like, but if you look at the Harvesters lost tab, we are seeing 39 of his workers have been lost, now down to only 38 Harvesters for Feifei. To an enormous number for Hero on 78. Hero has also taken this location, so he is currently macroing like crazy, and all we have to keep Feifei in the game are Infestors and a couple of Ultras and hardly any Lings, but he does have a ton more Lings in the way, so it'll be Baneling, Ling, Ultra, and the Banelings again being left behind, and another major engagement up here. The Infestors completely out of position, trying to fungle, trying to not be feedback. They are being feedback though, and the Ultras are ripping through the Stalkers, but all of these Archons I think will be a bit too much for Feifei to handle, but he still hasn't clicked on these Banelings. I don't know why he hasn't. Surely he sees them now and his Lings running around. Yes, he does, I believe. But we are seeing now Feifei run around to try and clean up this attack here. A couple of Immortals, a Ling Storm could be crucial though, could kill all those units. And we are seeing Ultras now, finally with full upgrades, ripping through the Archons, which have armor upgrades, not shield upgrades. So their shields are not armored, so the armor upgrades are not benefiting them very much. So the Ultra is going to do a nice job against these Archons. Although this attack still has not been cleaned up here, so many Lings dying, and you're also looking at the main being demolished by Lings and by Archons, and I think this will spell GG. So we are seeing Feifei just be cleaned up. Yeah, there's the GG, and that is the end of the game. So I love that by Hero. He just had units all over the place at the same time, being warped in by warp prisms. Warp prism used so well. In the next patch, they're actually going to buff warp prisms, so this sort of play will be even more powerful than it is now. Had one warp prism down here to attack the main with, one warp prism up here to attack the natural with. Also had units running in a side group here, as well as the main army at the front. And we were seeing a counterattack try to happen by Feifei, but he wasn't really doing anything. And Hero just had so many warp gates. I mean, look, can look at his camera, looking at Hero's camera. No, I can't really tell how many warp gates he has. It looks like 15. So 15 warp gates is going to be able to kill any number of Lings, because fully upgraded Zealots will kill fully upgraded Lings any day, and only 2 armor upgrades on the Lings in the end. Okay, so upgrades are crucial in that match. Just multi-pronged attacks are brilliant by our Hero. The early force fields, just controlling the pace of the game, was also brilliant, and I thought that was just a really, really good game to watch. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed today's match. I'm trying to upload a lot of content, but I might not be able to do that in weekdays. I can't guarantee that on the weekends. Certainly, I'll be uploading every day on the weekends and Fridays. So I hope you enjoyed this match. I guess I'll see you guys in my next cast. And thank you again to all the new subscribers, because my channel has been growing a lot lately, past 700. So thank you guys for all the support. And let's make a push for partnership and for 1,000 subs. I'm going to apply for partnership at 1,000 subscribers, by the way. But also do something special for you guys, the subscribers, which I haven't decided on doing what I'll do yet for that. But anyway, thanks all for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next cast.